Hi children, how are you? Today we are discussing new chapter, polynomials. So, chapter 3, polynomials. We have learned in previous class, that is 9th standard, polynomials. Okay? So, for example, what is a polynomial? Come on, tell me. For example, there are 6 rows and each row has 6 plants in a garden. So, 6 rows and each row has 6 plants in a garden. How many plants in a garden? Now, 6 into 6 equal 36. 6 into 6 equal 36. Now, there are 36 plants in a garden. Okay, now here using algebraic expression, that is into next the cost of tomatoes is 30 rupees for 1 kg. So 1 kg 30 rupees. That is tomatoes. Okay, now here, Sudha buys P cages. Sudha buys P cages. The same. Cherry buys Q cages. Next. Princey buys R cages. The cost of tomatoes 30 rupees per 1 kg. Here, Sudha buys P cages. That is P. Next, Cherry buys Q cages. Princey buys R cages. How much pay? Total amount. Okay, now here, Sudha buys P cages. Okay, now P into each cage rupees 30 rupees. 30 into P, 30 P. Same, Cherry. Cherry buys Q cages. Q into each cage 30 rupees. 30 Q. Next, Princey. Princey buys R cages. Each cage rupees 30. So, 30 R. Now, total amount, so total means adding, so total equal 30P plus 30Q plus 30R. Here, observe these two examples, use algebraic expressions, that is into and plus. Okay, now here, and algebraic expressions such as 3x square plus 7x, 3xy, pi r square, ax plus b is called polynomials. Okay, 3x square plus 7x, 3xy, pi r square, ax plus b and so on. These are called polynomials. Okay, here observe that a polynomial having positive integral power. First of all, 3x power 6. 3x power 6. Here, 6 is called degree or power. Degree or power. Now, x is called base. 3 is called coefficient. Okay. Understand? So, 6 is called power, x is called base, 3 is called coefficient. Okay? Now here, 3x square plus 7x plus 6. Here power is 2. Here power is 2. That is plus 2. Okay now? Here power is 2. That is plus 2. Now, it is known as polynomial. It is known as polynomial. Next. 4x power 7 plus 9x square plus 3x. Here power plus 7 and here also plus 2. Now it is known as polynomial. It is known as polynomial. Next, 4x square plus 9x power minus 4. Here having minus symbol. Now minus 4, it is negative power. Now it is not a polynomial. Okay, next, 6x square plus 1 by x power 4. 6x square plus 1 by x power 4. Now it is a polynomial or not? Now it is not a polynomial. Because 6x square plus 1 by x power 4. Now it will be x power minus 4. Formula 1 by a power n equal a power minus n. Okay, now the same. 1 by x power 4 write as x power minus 4. Now here minus symbol. Minus power. Okay, here negative power. Now it is not a polynomial. It is not a polynomial. These examples observe here. A polynomial having positive power. A polynomial having positive power. Or a polynomial having non-negative integral power. Non-negative means positive symbols. Okay, that is polynomials. Generally, we can say that P of x. P means polynomial. P means polynomial. P of x equal a0 x power n plus a1 x power n minus 1 plus a2 x power n minus 2 plus and so on plus an. So, it is general form of a polynomial. This is a general form of a polynomial. Now, P of x equal a0 x power n plus a1 x power n minus 1 plus a2 x power n minus 2 plus and so on. An. Okay, namma. So, it is a general form of polynomial. Here, a0, comma, a1, comma, a2 and so on, an are coefficients. Coefficients. Okay, Now, a0 is not equal to 0. a0 is not equal to 0. Okay, that is the general form of a polynomial. Okay, next. Next, degree of a polynomial. Degree of a polynomial. Now, we can take one polynomial, that is P of x equal 7x square plus 9x power 3 plus 8x power 7. Here, find the degree of a polynomial. Now, here, degree of a polynomial means the highest power is. The highest power is called degree of a polynomial. Here, highest power is 7. Highest power equals 7. So, that is degree of a polynomial. So, degree of a polynomial. Polynomial equal 7. The same. P of x equal 8x power 5 plus 9x square minus 6x. Find the degree of a polynomial. Here highest power is 5. Now here power 1. Here power is 1. Okay, now here highest power is 5. Now it is a degree of a polynomial. Therefore, degree of a polynomial. Degree of a polynomial equal 5. That is. Okay, that is the degree of a polynomial. Next, types of polynomials according to degree. of a polynomials according to degree. First, zero polynomial. Now here, zero polynomial. Zero polynomial means here degree equals zero. Degree is not defined. Here degree is not defined. That is example zero. Example zero. Okay, na? Zero polynomial. Zero polynomial means it is degree not defined. That is a zero. Here degree is not defined. Okay, na? Next, constant polynomial. Now constant. You know constant? For example, five. Okay, na? So here five. Here degree equal five is a constant. Now degree equal zero. Listen, five write as 5 into x power 0. X power 0. Now x power 0. A power 0 equal 1. Now 5 into 1 equal 5. Okay, na? That is, here constant polynomial means here degree equal 0. Okay, na? Next, third one. Linear polynomial. So example, a 9x plus 7. Here degree equal 1. Okay, so a polynomial degree having only 1, then it is linear polynomial. Example 9x plus 7. Now it is a linear polynomial. Here degree equal 1. Next, quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Quadra means 2. Example, when the degree is 2, then it is called quadratic polynomial. Example, 7x square minus 9x plus 6. 7x square, here degree equal 2. Now it is a degree of quadratic polynomial. Here degree equal 2. Next, cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. Cube means 3. Okay, when the degree is 3, then it is called cubic polynomial. Example, 3x cube plus 7x square plus 9x. Here highest degree is 3. Then it is called cubic polynomial. Here degree equal 3. That is. Okay, na? Are you understand? So, here, constant, zero polynomial, here degree is not defined. So, example, zero. Constant polynomial, when the highest power is zero, then it is called constant polynomial. That is example 5. Here, degree equal 0. Linear polynomial, here highest power is only 1. Then it is called linear polynomial. Example, degree equal 1. Next, quadratic polynomial. Here highest power is 2, then it is called quadratic polynomial. Here degree equal to cubic polynomial. Cubic means 3. Then the highest degree is 3, then it is called cubic polynomial. Here degree equal 3. That is the types of polynomials according to degrees. Next, same types of polynomials according to terms. Types of polynomials according to terms, types of polynomials according to terms. First one, monomial. First one, monomial. Monomial means here terms. Observe here terms. Term mono. Mono means only one. Only one. An algebraic expression or a polynomial having only one term, then it is called monomial. Okay na? A polynomial having one term, it is called monomial. That is 7x or 5. 7x or 5. Now it is 7x. No, it is single term. Now it is called monomial. It is also single term. Then it is called monomial. It is also a polynomial. 7x is a polynomial. 5 is also polynomial. Okay now. Next. Binomial. Here observe. Bi means two. Bi means two. Mono means one. Single term. Bi means two. A polynomial having only two terms. Then it is called binomial. Example. 7x minus 5. 7x minus 5. Now it is a binomial. Okay na? And it is also a polynomial. Okay. Next, third one. Trinomial. Tri. Tri means 3. Tri means 3. Okay. So 7x square plus 9x plus 6. Here having 3 terms. Number 1. Number 2, number 3, 3 terms having. Now it is called trinomial. Trinomial means a polynomial having 3 terms, then it is called trinomial. Okay na? Next, multinomial. Multinomial. Multinomial means more than 3 terms. A polynomial having more than 3 terms, then it is called multinomial. For example, 7x power 3 plus 9x square minus 6x plus 7. Here having more than 3 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now more than 3 terms, then it is called multinomial. Multinomial. Okay. Now it is here, it is a multinomial. It is also a polynomial. It is a multinomial. It is also a polynomial. It is a trinomial. It is also a polynomial. Binomial, it is a polynomial. Monomial, it is a polynomial. Okay, now 3x square 3x power 4 plus 8x cube plus 9x power minus 2 plus 8. It is a multinomial. It is a multinomial. But it is a polynomial. It is a multinomial. Okay, but it is a polynomial? No. Okay, now. Okay, so it is multinomial but not a polynomial. Okay, so 6x power 5 plus 7x cube 9x square plus 7x. It is a multinomial but it is a polynomial. It is a multinomial but it is not a polynomial. Here observe that. All polynomials having multinomial. It is polynomial and it is multinomial. Okay na? Now it is multinomial but it is not a polynomial. Okay, are you clear? All polynomials having multinomials, but all multinomials no need of polynomials. Okay na? All polynomials having a multinomial, but all multinomials no need to a polynomials. Okay, that is next. Next. Value of a polynomial. Of a polynomial. Here observe. Value of a polynomial. For example, P of x equal 3x square plus 9x. P of x equal 3x square plus 9x. So it is a polynomial. Now value of a polynomial means here substitute x equal x equal 1, x equal 2, x equal 0, x equal 3 and so on. Then the result is called value of a polynomial. Value of a polynomial. We have learned in previous class trial and error method. Put x equal 0, substitute, and x equal 1, substitute, x equal 3, and substitute. That, then the result is the value of a polynomial. For example, put x equal 0, p of 0, substitute x equal 0, 3 into 0 square plus 9 into 0. Now 3 into 0 square, 0. Plus 9 into 0, 0. Now value is 0. It is a value of a polynomial. Next, P of 1 equal 3 into 1 square plus 9 into 1. Okay. Now 3 into 1 square value 1. No. 3 1 is 3. 9 1 is 9. 3 plus 9, 12. Now it is a value of a polynomial. Next, P of 2 equal P of 2. 3 into 2 square plus 9 into 2. 3 into 2 square value 4 plus 9 2 is 18. So 3 4 is 12 plus 18 equal 30. 3 4 is 12 plus 18. 12 plus 18 equal 30. Now here observe that 0, 12, 30 is called value of a polynomial. Okay na? That is the value of a polynomial. Next, another example. P of x equal 9x square minus 7x. Okay, same. P of 0 equal 9 into 0 square minus 7 into 0. So, 0. Next, P of minus 1. P of minus 1. 9 into minus 1 square minus 7 into minus 1. So, 9 into minus 1 square value 1. Minus 1 square value 1. So, 9 into 1 plus 1. Minus, minus into minus plus. 7 1 is 7. 9 1 is 9 plus 7 equals 16. Okay, now here 0 and 16. These are called value of a polynomial. Okay, next, zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial. Now, we can take one polynomial, that is P of x equal x square minus 4. X square minus 4. Here, substituting P of 0, substitute x equal 0, 1 square minus 4. 1 square value 1 minus 4 equal minus 3. Next, P of 1, 1 square, okay, wait. P of 0, so 0 square value 0, so minus 4. Next, substitute P of 1, now x equal 1, 1 square minus 4. 1 square value same, 1 minus 4 equal minus 3. Now P of 2 equal, now substitute 2, 2 square minus 4. 2 square value 4 minus 4 equal 0. Next, P of minus 1, P of minus 1. So, now substitute x equal minus 1, substitute x equal minus 1. Minus 1 whole square minus 4. Minus 1 whole square. So, minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Minus 4 equal minus 3. Next, P of minus 2. Minus 2 whole square equal 4.
So minus 2 whole square. Minus 2 into minus 2. Minus 2 minus plus. 2 square value 4. 4 minus 4 equals 0. Now here observe. When the substitute x equal to. And when the substitute x equal to. Value is 0. When the substitute x equal minus 2. Value is 0. Now 2 and minus 2 is called zeros of a polynomial. Okay, now here 2 and minus 2 is called zeros of a polynomial. Why? Here result is 0. Here result is 0. Okay, now children. Therefore, 2 and minus 2 are zeros of a polynomial. Okay, now. Here 2 1 minus 2 are zeros of a polynomial. Here observe, in general you can say a real number, that is k, a real number that is k is said to be zeros of a polynomial if p of k equal 0. P of k equal 0, now it is a zeros of a polynomial. Okay, na? When the p of k equal 0, then it is zeros of a polynomial. Now k means constant, that is 2 1 minus 2. Or either one. That is 2 1 minus. Here having 2 1 minus 2. Okay, now we have to take any one. 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2. When the result is 0, that is the numbers are zeros of a polynomial. Are you understand? Okay.
Next, check whether, next example, most important, check whether three and minus three are zeros of the polynomial x square minus 9. Here given, most important, here given problem, check whether 3 and minus 3 are the zeros of the polynomial x square minus 9. That is zeros of the polynomial or not. Okay, now here given polynomial p of x equal x square minus, that is given polynomial p of x equal minus 9, x square minus 9. Now here substitute x equal 3, that is what time. Now substitute x equal minus 3, that is second. Okay, now p of 3. Now p of 3. Now substitute x equal 3. 3 square minus 9. Okay, now 3 square. 3 square value 9. Minus 9. 9 minus 9 equal 0. Next, p of minus 3. P of minus. Now substitute x equal minus 3. So here given x square minus 9. Now x value minus 3 whole square minus. Now minus 3 whole square. Minus 3 into minus 3. Minus 2 minus plus. 3 square value 9. 9 minus 9. 9 minus 9 equal 0. Now here result is 0. Here also 0. Therefore 3 and minus 3 are the zeros of the polynomial. Therefore 3 and minus 3 are zeros of the polynomial x square minus 9. That is okay, children. Most important. Okay, children. I will continue next class.